Hey guys, it's Mike Bowen. This is the fourth attempt at recording this thing. Mike Bowen, USA Triathlon Rules Ambassador for the Southeast region. And I got a day off from work. I'm at that time of the year, you know, where I've got to take some time down, you know, around the holiday season. I usually do it near the end of the year. You know, for triathletes, it's the end of the season. You know, most all the races here in the United States are done unless you're engaging in winter triathlon. I don't know how many people do that here in the U.S., but it's pretty popular over in Europe. But we'll talk about that some other time. But you know, so maybe you're getting into hibernation mode or holiday preparation mode. You know, doing some shopping or just getting some indoor training in. Get on the bike or the treadmill or in the pool and just chilling it out. For USA Triathlon officials, it's pretty much that sort of time between seasons. Also, you know, we start to take a look at what's coming up next year. What events are available? Especially if you're a national technical official, the ITU calendar is starting to fill up, so we can see what draft legal races are going to be going on and what opportunities we can have. But USAT, you know, during this time of the year. I'm sure that the leadership at the national office is working on the competitive rules official manual, which talks about all the procedures and things that we have to abide by, as well as the latest and greatest changes to any USAT competition rules that may come up. ITU also around this same time of the year, you know, puts out their competitive rule book in, you know, late November, December time frame, and then, you know, USAT follows up also with the National Technical Official Manual and, you know, pretty much lays out the procedures that we're going to use for draft legal racing. So we get a little bit of extra reading in over those nasty cold dark days of, you know, December, January time frame as we're getting ready for the new year. In much the same way that a lot of you guys probably take the time to maybe hopefully do a few hard run workouts or hard bike workouts on the trainer or the treadmill or getting in the pool and swimming hard. I like to take the time and I'll sit there and watch videotapes of races and stuff like that and just keep my head focused, my mind focused on positions and where people are on their bikes and what potentially could go wrong and where, you know, where I would be in a position in a situation like that. I don't do too much of that, but a little bit. I mean, I kind of like watching old races anyway, just to see where I've made, you know, where things have gone well and gone poorly for officials. I took the time to look at a couple of videos that I had done as part of a race earlier in the year, and I was like, oh my God, I can't believe I missed a particular point and didn't tell an athlete about something that would have potentially left them violating a rule. But that's a different story. Other than that, I'm going to take the time, no doubt, to look at least at my bicycle back here. You know, it's been you know, a very faithful friend of mine. You know, I use it for when I'm officiating local races or, you know, non-drafting races. I'll take it down to my friends at the Trek bike store and let them take a look at it and make sure that all the tires are good to go and the chains are good to go and I've got everything all lubricated, calibrated and adjusted correctly so that I have an easy time next season keeping up with people on the run course. Also, yeah, it's my helmet's about 9 years old. This is my motorcycle helmet, trusty old helmet that I've had since I became a USAT official. Use it for both Ironman and ITU and the USAT non-drafting races. Been about 9-10 years to have it, and I'm finding that you know, my head's getting big, and as I get big in my old age, and might be a good time as any to replace it with a new one. My bicycle helmet is good to go pretty much. I've had one for about 2 years now that's brand new. Passed my older helmet off to my loving bride for her to use on her get around bicycle. You might want to take the time to look at your helmet and make sure that everything's in good condition, that the interior, the polystyrene is not cracked. I know I talked about this a few videos back when I was talking about the $20 helmet thing. Make sure that your helmet is good, your straps are all in good order and everything. Take the time to, take the time to go ahead and replace that helmet if you start seeing it, start seeing excess wear and tear on it. If you've had it for a few years, it's probably a good idea. Also, take the time and see, can you find the U.S. Product Safety Commission sticker in there? If you can't find the sticker in the helmet, it's probably a good time to go ahead and either take it down to the local bike shop to let your local bike guy show you where the sticker is, or go ahead and get a brand new helmet and learn where that sticker is. You know, no sticker, no race. That's pretty simple. Okay. As I said, this is just a mishmash of stuff that I'm just crossing my mind. Oh, by the way, yeah, you may want to look at your wetsuit right now while it's, you know, while you're leading into the holiday. I know that there are manufacturers that are putting out good sale opportunities. Might be a good time to go ahead and get a brand new wetsuit. If you've got tears and stuff in it, or you've stretched it out over the course of the previous few seasons, yeah, go ahead and take a look at one. That's about all I've got to say, and I promise, as always, I'll do better next time. And you probably hear something from me after the New Year's. I hope you have a great winter holiday and a fantastic new year, and we'll talk to you again really, really soon, okay? Take care. Bye-bye.